I want to tell you something really funny about humans. We don't like to admit it when we drop the ball and make mistakes. And yet that's one of the best ways to learn things. When we make mistakes with data in our science experiments, it's critical to admit it and then correct it so that others won't be misled and don't make the same mistake. Correcting errors in our published articles protects our reputation and that of the journals where the mistakes were published. It also shows our willingness to do what's in the best interest of science and for those who rely on the data that we publish now and in the future. I mention that because I recently published a paper where I described an important, easy-to-make error that I and apparently many other cover crop researchers have made. This error involves the misuse of sampling quadrats like this that can inadvertently lead to inaccurate estimates of cover crop biomass data and associated metrics like soil carbon inputs. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to give you a brief overview of the quadrat misuse problem, highlight some common related mistakes that I found in the recent cover crop literature, and also give you a few tips to help improve your cover crop research. Now, I'm not going to go into all the details of the paper, so I encourage you to get a copy so that you can review it all and look at all the colorful diagrams and details there. Now, before I get into the technical details of my paper, I want to mention the awkward writing style of many sentences in the paper, where I refer to myself more than 30 times in the third-person voice as the author. It's a great example of how not to write a scientific paper. Now, that writing style, it wasn't my choice. I wanted to use the first-person voice that's a more engaging, clear, and concise writing style. But unfortunately, the editors wouldn't allow that. But I also wanted my paper published in the Agronomy Journal because I think that that's where it'll have the most visibility and potential impact because that journal is a leading publication for reporting cover crop research. So to get my paper accepted, I reluctantly rewrote it in the third-person voice. All right, so what's this issue with quadrat misuse in cover crop research? Let's start with some basics. Quadrats are areas of an experimental plot that are often demarcated by a lightweight frame made of wood, plastic, or metal. I've used quadrats in my research to sample cover crop shoot biomass, weeds, and even bird droppings. Now keep in mind that the problems that I'll be describing with quadrats apply to cover crops that are planted in rows, usually with a grain drill, not to cover crops that are broadcast seeded. And this brings me to tip number one. In articles with drilled cover crops, the row spacing should always be provided because it affects a lot of different aspects of cover crop performance. Now, unfortunately, row spacing information was missing from about 40% of the recent papers that I reviewed on cover crops. Quadrats are often rectangular, but they can also be other shapes, and that's why it's problematic if you just report the area of the quadrat without its dimensions. This is another very common mistake in many cover crop articles. So here's tip number two. If you use a quadrat to sample your cover crops, only use rectangular ones. And always report the inner dimensions and make sure that the quadrat width is perpendicular to the rows. And that leads me to tip number three. The width of the quadrat that's perpendicular to the rows should always be a multiple of the row spacing. This is where many serious sampling problems can occur. For example, let's say that your row spacing is 6 inches. Your quadrat width could be 6 inches or 12 inches or 18 inches, regardless of the length of the quadrat. You might be wondering, why does the width of the quadrat need to be a multiple of the row spacing? There's two important reasons. First is, if the quadrat width is not a multiple of the row spacing, it can be unclear to people reading your articles or following your methods to know how many rows of the cover crop were sampled. Let's consider an example where the cover crop rows are spaced 6 inches apart and the quadrat width is 50 centimeters. This was the case in many of my studies. That quadrat width is not a multiple of the row spacing and could be placed over 3 or 4 rows. But the reader won't know that unless you state that in the materials and methods part of your cover crop publications. Now, the second reason that the quadrat width should be a multiple of the row spacing is because if it's not, it can easily lead you to incorrectly calculate the cover crop biomass per unit area. Here's why. Let's just say that you use a 50 by 50 centimeter quadrat, and then you state that in your article that it covered three rows. And then you take that area of the quadrat, 50 by 50, or 2,500 square centimeters, and you use that to calculate the biomass per unit area. Unfortunately, your calculation would be incorrect, because the quadrat area actually extends into neighboring rows that were not sampled. The area allocated to the three rows that you sampled is actually 2,286 square centimeters, not 2,500 square centimeters. That's the mistake that I made with many of my cover crop articles, and it's why a lot of my cover crop biomass data underestimates it by 9%. My paper has lots of examples of these calculations and how this affects the accuracy of biomass sampling. And it can range from underestimating it by 49% to overestimating it by 27%. And things can get even more complicated and messy if you're using quadrats to sample biomass of cover crops that occurs in rows and weeds that don't occur in rows. Check out my paper for more details on that complexity. Like I said, we all make mistakes. It's part of being a human. It's also the best way to improve. I hope that the mistakes that I described here and in my paper help you and others to improve the rigor and accuracy of your cover crop research. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Thanks for listening, and take care.